Well, Gary, good result and a very impressive first half in particular.
Yeah, I felt we played really well first half. I thought Ayr came right back into it the first 20 minutes of the second half. You know, they had the majority of the ball. But, you know, delighted with the result. A very difficult place to come. And you know, we're obviously delighted to get 3 points.
Good footballing conditions today, and people like Bobby Barr down the left here especially was impressive.
Yeah, he was very impressive, and it's obviously credit to the ground staff here. You know, the state the pitch is in, it was magnificent to play football on. But I think you can see with our first half performance, you know, the boys enjoyed it. But we've got a long way to go. You know, it's only the first game of the season. There's certainly a long way to go, but delighted to get 3 points.
The second goal really killed it. Yeah, pulled the steam out of Ayr really as well.
Yeah, it did. Obviously, you know, put Rudy on. He's a wee bit behind in terms of his fitness, but you know, one thing I know about Rudy, he'll get into the positions and he'll always make the goalkeeper work, whether he scores or, you know, whether the goalkeeper parried it like he did. Delighted for young Ross Matthews to get his first goal for the club.
You seem to be going for quite an attacking setup. Is that how you hope to? Is that what you hope is your style for this season?
Yeah, I think, you know, I'm a manager that likes to try and have a go. I think that's what the fans come to football to see. They want to be entertained. We feel as if we've got players with pace and players that will beat people. So, you know, we're delighted with today's performance, but there's a long, long way to go.
The club had a good season last year, good finishing place as well this season. Step forward, are you going to be really challenging for that title?
Well, it'll be difficult. You know, I think the outstanding favourites in the league are Hibs and Dundee United with the resources they've got. As I touched on there, you know, it's one win. We're certainly not going to get carried away with that. It's a long, hard season. You might get injuries, suspensions, and that can catch up with you. So we feel as if we've got a decent squad of players, but I'm pretty sure every other manager in this league will say the same. So it's a good win for us at a really difficult venue, and we've just got to make sure we try and build on it next week.
Thanks very much. Well, Neil, absolutely amazing that you are. I think we can now tell people that you've been announced as a new assistant manager for Ayr United. What does that mean to you?
Obviously, it means a lot, becoming an assistant manager, but to be fair, my role doesn't change that much. I was doing a lot of the same stuff last year as well, but it just means there's a wee bit of extra workload on my shoulders now that John's away.
Well, John, you've mentioned it, John. Have you felt with him leaving the club? Other than that, gives you a great benefit, obviously. But
it's obviously a great benefit, John, going, but I had a good relationship with John. But when a club like Blackburn comes calling for you in the position that he's getting, then it's a great opportunity for him.
Does it change much for the club in the way that we go forward?
No, I think we've already had the same foundations from day one since I got here. We do the same things. Things are set up very similar. Just means there's just myself setting most of the stuff up.
So basically what you're saying, that gives you more of a target now for the gaffer, you to shout at instead of two people?
I'll be taking most heat for the gaffer instead of splitting it between John. But it's a great opportunity, so.
And after a game like this today, where Ayr have lost there, what's your role now with those boys in the dressing room?
To be fair, like I said, my role doesn't really change. I would still have been doing the same last year as first team coach is what I would be doing as assistant manager. But it's just lifting the boys for the next game, make sure we're ready and prepared for going into the Aberdeen game. Out doing cool downs, speaking to boys, where you think we should be improving, what we should be working on. But to be fair, my position's changed, but what I'm doing is not really much of a difference between what I was already doing, if you know what I mean.
Well, all the best for this season as well then, Neil.
Thank you very much.
Well, it's a disappointing return, and I think you might agree with me when you say the first half was probably not the best for Ayr United, a bit off the pace.
Yeah, but we just made too many basic errors. I mean, a big thing I say to them is we can't, at this level, invite pressure on ourselves. You know, and at times if it doesn't look great, and it goes, well, fine, it has to go, and, you know, give the ball away in their defensive third, not. We spent the first 25 minutes of the game giving the ball to them in really dangerous areas, and it was really, really poor. And the players know that, it's an honest bunch. But we did get back in it in the first half, and I thought Paul Kane had a great move, great bit of play, and he should really have scored. But, you know, if you're brutally honest, we could have been a couple down by that point. But second half, I thought we started very brightly. And the first, that was our best period of the game, first 15-20. And Allen's, who I thought was terrific, I thought Alan Forrest did really well today. I thought he should have scored. He knows himself. It's a great chance. And at this level, it just puts a different complexion on it. 1-1, our crowd gets up, we're on the front foot. And, I think it was minutes later, they have a breakaway and end up scoring a goal and killed the game.
Yes, that breakaway was a real kick in the teeth for the team, as they seemed to be putting more and more pressure on, making chances, and then suddenly the stuffing went out of them a bit.
Yeah, I think, I mean, I don't know when they scored their second goal. Was it maybe 10, 20 minutes to go? After that, I don't think we threatened. I really don't. I don't think they did, but they killed the game. And, you know, it's an experienced Championship team that finished the top four last year. But it's at Somerset Park, we should be looking to beat all the teams here, including Raith Rovers. And, you know, the catalyst, the whole turning point on the game for me was we've hung in well. And when we did have a really good period in the game, you know, we've got to score our chance, which was a terrific chance.
Another one there was Kearney, looked about to head of the ball straight into the net from what, 6 yards out, if even that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a penalty kick all day long, and I think maybe the referee admitted as much to me that I think it was influenced by the fact that he didn't give their one, which I thought probably was a penalty kick as well. But two wrongs don't make it right. I think he should still have given it, and that might have been a turning point in the game as well. But, you know, we're going to have lots of ups and downs this year. You know, we've got to just remain really, really positive. We had a great cup tie to look forward to, and then down at Queen of South. So, listen, we worked our socks off to get here. We've got to enjoy it.
You did say that you thought Forrest had a really good game up front, and certainly he did, but there was a big difficulty against this level of defending as well. If I can remember his name, Mvoto, himself was a big brick wall, hard to get round, very tall. What can you do?
I thought Forrest moved around at times, though. You know, the way he play against guys like that is moving them around, getting about their feet. You know, he's not as clever on the day. But, I mean, he's playing the Championship in England, so... I think Gary tried to take him at heart. So, I mean, I think he's a big boy, he's decent. I wouldn't say he's a world beater, in my opinion. And I thought Alan caused him problems in the first half with his movement and his touch.
So now we go on to Wednesday, a completely different match against Aberdeen. Different possession totally. How do you start getting the boys up for that one again?
Oh, listen, I've told them this season will be ups and downs. You know, there's no doubt about that, but, you know, you can never... lose your spirit. You've got to have that every time you play and every time you pull on the jersey. And Wednesday, I think, will take care of itself. I think it'll be a really good atmosphere under the lights here when they go on. You know, and it's a game we've got nothing to lose. We're not expected to do anything. We're going to go and try and win.